St. John to Copeland's camp. It's done. The radio tower's locked down. I've restored your radio uplink.
Copy that. You may not see the value in St. John, but Radio Free Oregon is the only thing keeping us from turning into savages.
Now, Copeland will keep us from turning into savages. About 9 square meals. Try going hungry for 3 days. There's no such thing as a starving patriot.
Well, sir, I hope to God you're wrong about that. But out.
Radio Free Oregon. Jesus, what have I done?
Boozman, you awake? I'm heading to that camp you spotted north of the mountain.
I heard gunshots. Might be an ambush camp.
Find out when I get there. Deacon out.
Deke, you there? I got bored. Figured I'd see if I remembered how to make anything. Stop by when you can. I think you'll like it.
Oh, Boozer, that's amazing. Yeah, I do need some. Deacon out. Booze man, you were right. They set up along the railroad tracks.
Kill every one of those sons of bitches.
Was kind of the plan. Deacon out. Could use this again.
That should do it.
Oh, my cover.
That's the last of them. Stay the hell off O'Leary Mountain. Boozer, it's done. Squatter camp.
They won't be doing any more killing on O'Leary Mountain.
Good. Deke, I should have been there. To help, I mean, I...
Shit. Just rest up, Booze Man. Rest up. We're riding north as soon as your arm heals. You got that?
Yeah, I hear you. Booze, you're out.
Yeah, I'm gonna ride up to the cemetery and see if I can find Leon's stash.
Sorry. What was that?
Rest up, loser. We're heading north as soon as you can ride.
North. Yeah.
I was thinking about heading down to that logging camp, around those nests. I'd see more freaks up here.
Boozer, no! No, you're gonna get yourself killed. You gotta wait till you're whole, brother. I'm over here anyway, so I'll take care of the mess, okay?
Yeah, okay. Thanks, Dad.
Still light out. There'll be more of them, but they won't be as strong.
Mass grave.
Why'd they bury this shit out here again? Oh, yeah, because they're assholes.
Deke. Oh, God damn it. I'm sick and tired of drifters coming in my camp, killing folk like we were out in the shit.
What's going on, Cope?
A man come in, drugged out of his mind, shot the place up, then he just took off. Then he said his bike's got a red tank on it, and he was wearing some kind of motocross helmet, silver.
Okay, if I go now, I might be able to catch up to him.
I want him alive, Deke.
Alive?
Alive. You catch this man, then radio me. We'll fetch him and hang the bastard right from that limb. It's time we start showing these drifter sons of bitches that we have law and order in this camp. No offense meant to yourself.
None taken. I'll find him. Way out to the roof.
Deke, you there? Did you say you were heading north?
Booze Man, no. You know I wouldn't ride north without you.
Yeah, I know. I just kinda am out of it.
Well, third degree burns will do that to you.
Yeah. So... take care of Alvarez, you know. Deke, it means a lot to me.
I'll take care of her, Boozer. Just get some rest. Deacon out.
Deke, you there? Did you say you were heading north?
Booze Man, no. You know I wouldn't ride north without you.
Yeah, I know. I just kinda out of it.
Well, third-degree burns will do that to you.
Hey, man. So, take care of Alvarez, you know. Think. It means a lot to me.
I'll take care of her, Boozer. Just get some rest. Deacon out.
Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. Who remembers the skid rows of this great country? People living on the streets in boxes and tents because they couldn't afford the American dream. Some of those good people fought for this very country, only to have the feds forget about them as soon as they were done with them. PTSD doesn't stand for post-traumatic stress disorder. It stands for put them soldiers down. Well, we're all homeless now, living in the wilderness in the way of our forebears. The feds used to think we needed their welfare and handouts to survive. We showed them how wrong they were. What we need now is a strong will, determination, and trust in each other. The feds were never going to give us that. And you? You want our trust? You gotta earn it. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
That's great. That's great. Radio Free Oregon is on the air once again. Oh, Jesus, what have I done?
Appreciate it. Open out.
take a closer look. All right, where? Still got this. This is it. Oh, Jesus, something went down. Wonder if the poor bastards had anything worth looking for.
Back on track.
I gotta burn him out. I gotta make it safer to ride. Get you now.
Ooh, I know.
weeping angel. This has got to be it. Now, where'd you hide the stash, Leon? What do we got? Maybe in one of these. Got it. Now I just gotta figure out who I'm gonna give this to.
Boozer! Boozer man, you listening? You're not gonna believe this. I just saw a goddamn chopper!
A chopper? What are you talking about?
NERO Chopper! It just buzzed right over me and acted like I wasn't even there!
Wait, all this time and a Fed chopper shows up out of nowhere?
I'm gonna chase them down and I'm gonna see what the hell they're doing!
Hey, Deke. Be careful. Don't get too close to them. Don't do anything stupid.
Hell no, I'm not gonna do anything stupid! Hold on, they're slowing down. Looks like they're stopping.
Could be
Drifter
friends now,
will
yeah?
Open fire.
Okay, that ought to distract them.
Getting hungry? Yeah, I'm starving. It's freezing up.
Check the thermo in your suit.
Field note 000.
After tracking a large moving group, estimated size of 500 to 600, we have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at...
Hey, Doc, I see Site-23 on the roster for tomorrow. Is that us?
No, that's O'Brien.
Got it.
Shit, where was I? We have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at the High Desert Grotto, now designated Site-15. trampling of grasses and plants at the entrance and the presence of footprints, see attached photos, indicate the site has been used for some time.
Must be nice and cozy in there.
According to the motion sensor planted by Lieutenant O'Brien, approximately 447 subjects have entered the cave this morning. Recommend sending a follow-up team sometime after 1900 hours to assess the cave's interior and further assess conditions. Note to Dr. Anderson, your theory about the subjects devolving to a primitive state of nocturnal behavior is seeming more appealing all the time. End report.
Not going inside.
Fucking O'Brien.
Did you hear me? Over 400 subjects, and these aren't just your regular run-of-the-mill freaks. These are from Stage 3.
I've been looking slow at my face.
And I asked if you were going in. Didn't say I was.
These subjects are not sleeping. They're hibernating. Ever woken up a hibernating bear?
No.
Ever woken up a hibernating freak?
Yeah, actually. I was one of the survivors of the White King Mine.
Jesus.
Someone tear my buddy apart like he was peeling a banana. These suits protect you from a lot of shit. Not them.
Holy shit, Corporal. Jesus, I'm sorry.
That mission was foobar from the start.
Which is why we are not going inside there.
I think if I sealed up this cave, we'd knock down their population.
I don't know, Corporal. A lot of caves out here. Come on, let's get out of here.
See what that means. Yeah, right. Like anyone gives a damn.
There? Booze man, come back. The Nero guy, the soldier, whatever the hell he was, who took Sarah.
What are you?
He had an ID badge. What was the name?
Oh, God, O'Brien. He wouldn't shut up about it. All the way out to Three Finger Jack.
Okay, he's alive, Boozer. He's alive.
What are you talking about? We were there. The whole camp was wiped out.
Now, I know that, but I heard... Okay, look. I went into their LZ, and they...
Wait, you went into their LZ? What the...
Just listen to me. I heard them over the radio. They were talking about a man named O'Brien.
Deke, don't.
I'm not, Boozer. I'm not. I'm just... Hey, get some sleep. Deacon out.
Which way? There you are. Okay. Okay, let's see. What's going on here? Gotcha. see me, I gotta get my gear.
I got a use for you.